and I.
Go again.
It's all yours, man.
You know, most people don't get to see what I see standing from here, from this point. I see beautiful people. And it's a Kodak moment. And so I want to invite Derek to come on up here and let him see what I see. Come on over here, Derek. Derek, do you see what I see? Do you see beautiful people?
I do.
Look into each other's eyes like you really love each other.
Not like you said.
Now look this way with a wonderful smile. Say yes. All right. Thank you, Derek. I'm glad you were able to capture this Kodak moment. Because, as I said, you don't often get this shot, this picture here, with lovely people who have come to show their love and encouragement and support. And so, at this point in time, I want to offer prayer. Father in heaven, as we come to you in prayer, we thank you, Father, for this opportunity to be here, to be a part of this wonderful relationship and this union. We invite you to be here, fill our thoughts and our hearts. May it be filled with the love of Jesus, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Love never ends, but as the prophecy is, they will come to an end. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. And now, faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love.
We are here to celebrate and share in the glorious act that God is about to perform, which is commended by the Apostle Paul to be honorable above all men, and this relationship is a sacred one. It is not to be entered into lightly. And so I make it a practice, kind of like a, are you sure? And so I'm going to ask the question, are you sure you want to get married?
Oh, yes.
Okay, all right. We're going to move forward then. And I want to share with you the Ten Commandments of Marriage. Number one, thou shalt have no other human being before your husband or your wife. Prioritize your partner over everyone. Number two, thou shalt put no thing before your husband or wife. Number three, thou shalt not belittle, criticize, or find fault, but rather encourage your spouse in all ways. Number four, remember the vows you take this day as you face life's challenges. Number five, thou shalt honor and respect your spouse. Number six, thou shalt not destroy the spirit within your spouse. Do not attempt to take away their individuality. Allow God to transform them to be the person he wants them to be. Number seven, thou shalt give your passions only to each other, not to another. You should not give away your passions to another in word, in thought, or in deed. Number eight, thou shalt not steal quality time away from your spouse. If anything, make time for each other. Take time to talk and do things together. Don't expect your spouse to be a mind reader. A relationship takes work, compromise, and a lot of understanding. Most of all, it takes communication. Just because you're in love with your spouse doesn't mean that all will run smoothly. Number nine, thou shalt not bear false witness to each other. Be honest with each other. Dishonesty and an unwillingness to talk through differences build a silent wall which is not easily dismantled. Number 10, be content with one another, with the one whom God has given to you, and God will bless your lives together. These commandments can be expanded in greater detail, but not today, not now. Getting married is easy. Getting a license is easy. And and bring the license with me. Oh, it's over here. Yeah, don't toy with you. I've got the license here. And how hard was it to go get it? It was easy, right? They just said, hey, I've got some money. We want to get married, and can we get the papers? And they gave it to you, right? They didn't say, well, fill out this long survey. They gave it to you. And I just want, I want to give you an object lesson, okay? That's all your hard work. This is just paper. It doesn't make the marriage. And by the way, this is not the original, okay? I'm going to get that paper. It's not the original. I told you to trust me. I'm glad you did. I'm glad you didn't strike at me. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Okay, good. I'll hold tight. Which brings me to another point. That paper, that's all it is. It doesn't make the marriage. And which brings me to another point. If problems